Welcome to our channel Education for Everyone, and this is the third video of our video series related to interview questions on computer networking. And if you are here for the first time, please go through all the other videos related to this video series. And if you need this presentation which I am using in this video, please go through the link description of this video. Alright, let us start with the first question which we are having here. That what are cookies? So cookies are just a piece of information which is provided by the website or web server to a user at the time of interaction or at the time of first interaction. So in the future, when a user visits the same website, so it will just send this cookie where all the interaction from the previous session is saved to the from the website. And the website will know that what are the likes and dislikes of this user. So what are the things which are saved in the cookies? So the names, address, passwords, and what are the credit card numbers. So these are the things which are saved in the cookies. Also, we had discussed session ID in the previous video. So those session IDs are also saved in cookies. Okay. So cookies were designed to a reliable mechanism for websites to remember stateful information, because as we know that HTTP is not a stateful protocol. Okay, it doesn't remember the state of the connection. Okay, so that's why cookies mechanisms was introduced in the connection or communication. So the next question arises is that where are the cookies stored? So cookies are stored on the client side. Okay, these are not stored on the server side. These are stored on the browser or the user's machine. Okay, so the other question is, what are autonomous systems? So let me change the pointer option. So in today's market, there are different companies, there are different network operators which are using their own internet protocols. Okay, so what they will do is that there are different types of protocols which are there in the market. So suppose there are P1, P2, P3. These are the three protocols which are there in the market. So all the machines which are using P1 or all the machines which are connected through one network operator, we can consider all those machines. So let's suppose this is machine, this is one machine, and this is one machine, and this is connected to P1. So all these are accessing P1, and in the same way there are different machines which are accessing different protocols. So for all these machines, we can term these all machines as one autonomous system. So what we can say is that autonomous system are the collections of devices who are supporting one type of protocol. Okay, so this is one autonomous system, this is other autonomous system, and the way these autonomous systems are connected. So these autonomous systems are connected through one special protocol which is known as BGP, means Border Gateway Protocol, and this is unique to all the other autonomous systems. Okay, so there cannot be many types of border gateway protocols. There can only be one border gateway protocol that all other autonomous system protocols have to follow. Okay, so these protocols or autonomous system can support their own protocols, but for connection of all these autonomous system, we have to consider border gateway protocol into the picture. Okay, so let us move on to the other question, that what is the difference between put and post? There is one simple difference between these two, that if the number of times, means if the multiple number of times you are accessing the data from the post method, each time the data will be the different. Okay, each time the result will be different, produced output will be different. But in the case of put, when we are using put method, the result will always be the same irrespective of the number of times you are accessing through put, means put method. The result will be the same, but it is not the same in the case of post method. So I have made another slide for the for clearing the confusion between put and post. So you can read it from read it on your own. Okay. So let us move on to the next question. That what are torrents? So simply telling that torrents are simply files, okay, which are holding the information that whatever the information you want to access, where are they reside, okay? So suppose if you want some big chunk of information, this is I, okay? And on the torrent network, it is distributed among different machines in the way I1, I2, I3, okay? So what this torrent file will hold the information, it will hold the address of all this I1, I2 and I3, and it will save the address of all these, address of I1, address of I2 and in the same of I3. And when you want to access all this information, you will access this torrent file, and with the help of this torrent file, you will get to know that there is some information which is here and which is here, and in the same way I3, and you will go through all these information, collect it, and you will get this I. Okay, so this is the concept of torrent. Now how torrent works? So the better question is how torrent network works. Okay, so how torrent network works is, whenever a machine wants to enter any torrent network, it has to first register itself through a tracker which is there in the torrent network. So this is a tracker and this is one torrent network. Okay, so suppose a machine which is coming into the torrent network, firstly it has to register itself. This tracker will give a unique ID to this machine, okay, and it will also give one suitable neighborhood. Suppose this is the neighborhood and this is other neighborhood, so this tracker will check what is the neighborhood which is suitable for this machine, what it wants to access. So this machine one will tell that I want this information, okay, and then this tracker will decide whether this machine neighborhood for this machine is this neighborhood, means this machine should be connected here, or this machine should be connected here. So this tracker will provide this neighborhood to the machine. Okay, after the information is accessed from the machine one from this neighborhood, then it is up to this machine that it wants to leave the network or it wants to stay in the network. Okay, so these are the terminologies of the torrent network, that what are seeds and what are leeches. So simply telling, seeds are more of a giving and leeches are more of taking. So all the machines which are uploading the data or information on the torrent network, these are considered as seeds. So seeds are giving, uploading or giving. Okay, so you can say that these are the giving machines of the torrent. Okay, and leeches are all the machines which are downloading the data from the torrents. Okay, so these are the machines which are downloading or taking. So this is the difference between seeds and leeches, and it is asked mostly in interviews, that in most interviews they will ask that do you know what is torrent, how it works, and what is the what are the machines known as seeds and leeches. Okay, the next question is, what are gateways? So you should simply know that inside a network there are some border routers. Okay, there are some machines which are installed on the border of the network. Suppose this is network one and this is internet. Okay, so all the packets which are coming out or from outside of the internet, means outside of this network, which are coming from the internet to this network, they should have to pass through gateways. Okay, and all the packets which are going out from this network to the internet, they should also pass through gateway. So what is it? It serves as a entry and exit point of the network. So all the messages which are going out from the network and all the messages or packets which are coming from the outside, they have to pass through gateways. Okay, there can be multiple gateways inside a network. Suppose you can see in this network that there are two machines which can act as a gateway. This is router, this is switch, and they can they both can be means act they can both act as gateway routers or gateway switches for this network. Okay, so these this is data communication device that provides a remote network with connectivity to a host network. Okay, so the question is, what is multicasting? Okay, so multicasting is a type or it is a process in which only one machine is if it wants to distribute the data to more than one machine, in that case it will use the multicasting concept. So suppose this is machine A and these are the other machines inside the network, and if this A wants to means distribute a copy, this is copy C, and it wants to send this copy to more than one machine. Suppose this is 1, 2, and 3. So if it wants to distribute this copy C to all these machines 1, 2, 3, it will be using multicasting phenomenon. Okay, so let's read this once. In computer networking, multicast is a group communication where data transmission is to a group of destination. Okay, so what is the difference between multicasting and broadcasting? In broadcasting, this copy is distributed to all the machines. Okay, so it will be distributed to this machine, and this machine as well. So in the case, if all the machines in the group are getting the copy which is sent by the A, then in that case it will be the broadcasting. But if you are sending to only some group, then it will be multicasting. So we can say that broadcasting is a special case of multicasting. Okay, and you can access the video. I have made one video related to multicasting. You can access through this link. And this is the last question of this video, that which protocol does Gmail uses for mail accesses? So there are two protocols which can be used by Gmail, and sometimes it is using POP, means post office protocol, and it is also using internet mail access protocol, which is also known as IMAP. So POP means post office protocol is the simplest of all the mail protocol or mail access protocol, and it is this IMAP is more of a derived one from the POP. So Gmail can access both of these at one time. And in the next video we will start with the disadvantages of RIP. So that's all about this video. In next video, as I had said, that we will discuss RIP. Also guys, please like, share and subscribe this channel so I can reach more number of viewers. And alright, meet you in the next video. Till then, thank you.